Okay, let's get started. It's tire time. You know what I do need? Yeah, some more washers for that. And it didn't come with enough washers. But luckily, I have washers here, and then quarter key goes through there to lock the wheel in place. So, need to go scout me up some flat washers. Since the cart was shipped with these thin washers missing, and I just went to a big box store to see if I can get a replacement, I couldn't because of a thinness. Too much of a hassle to pack everything up and send it back, the cart that is, because it's missing three washers. But it's a non-standard washer. It's 5/8 inch, which matches the diameter of the axle. And the thick one would work, except I don't have much room to work down here in order to get to the hole for the quarter key pin to go into. So we'll give it a try and see what happens. The quarter key here will do most of the work. Yeah. Sometimes MacGyver has to MacGyver it. Close enough for ranch work. Check the air pressure first on these. And then we'll carry on and put the second cart together. But this first cart didn't have enough parts with it. Okay, it's set to PSI. £6. And the tire will go up to 30 PSI. So let's put 25 in. Let's put 25 in. Let's read this now. It was 6. Now it's 24. And just give it a little squirt more. It's not much volume here, so it shouldn't take a whole heck of a lot. Okay, let's see what we got this time. 27, a little bit too much. 27. I let too much out. So we'll try a little bit more. Twenty-five. I'll take it. I'll take it at 25. Okay, so we're going to do that to all four tires. And then we're going to replace my McIver thing here, my little yellow rubber spongy thing, for a washer, and with a real washer that we got from the company. Company was very nice. They had received about a month of calls about not enough hardware parts in these carts, kits that were delivered to customers like myself. And I said, well, I actually bought two of these carts, and I've only put one of the carts together, and it was short. When I got down to the wheels, it was short, three wash flat washers to hold the Carter key thing in. And they're very nice. And they said, okay, well, we'll send you out two more hardware packages. And they did. And I was expecting the pack to have all the stuff that the other pack had, including more washers. And all I got was four washers. You'll see the picture in a minute. We'll look at the little manual, and it shows 30 millimeter 17 millimeter flat washer, a quantity of 11, and it ain't got 11. Then you go further into the assembly instructions, and it says for that 30 by 17 millimeter flat washer, you need 8 of them. And it only came with 4 in the package. Bottom line, at the end of the assembly of this first cart, I was short by 3 of these washers. But I got the washers now, and I'll go ahead and install those. Okay. Now we're going to replace these little cushiony things with the actual washer, flat washer, that I got from the company after I called them, which was good. Okay, so let's straighten this bad boy back out. And we no longer need my little rubber thing. I don't know if that would have done any good or not. Probably not, too soft. Okay. Here's the flat washer. You see how flat it is. Way flatter than you can get in a hardware store. At least most hardware stores. So I'll put that down over the axle. I thought if they were going to send me out a hardware package that had the 11 quantity in there, I would have put a washer on the inside of the axle down here, which has some grease on it, lubricating, I guess. And I would have put a washer here, then the tire, and then another washer. But I still don't have enough washers. So I have to do it this cheap way, I guess. Well, there's the axle with the washer on. Put the Carter key back in. I'm just going to give it a little bend. It doesn't need much. All this Carter key thing is doing is keeping the washer from falling off. And the tire has 25 PSI, and the tire is rated for 30 PSI. And as we just found out, and I checked all four of these tires. They were between 6.5 and 8 pounds. Of course, it came from Indonesia, so it's not uncommon for it to leak out like that. Okay, and I'm going to do the other three wheels, and then I am going to put on the fencing part for the cart, so I can make a wagon. Instead of a flat cart, I'll have an actual wagon, and we'll show that in a moment. But I'm going to do the rest of the tires now. Okay, the cart is ready to get the side slats on over there. But this thing's been bugging me, this tow bar. All the other two carts, this bar is across this way. It looks like you got a box here with a bolt through it, pin. You got a pin down here, a hole, only one hole. I just found the trick on how to twist this at 90 degrees. Here we go. Take the pin off. Take the bolt out and pull this off. This will go into the back of a trailer or something. But if I turn the plate this way and stick it in, I'm not sure. Let's see what that does. Probably nothing. Nope, won't go that way. It won't go that way, so this is twisting. There's a piece of rubber on here. And if this had holes in the top, maybe I can take this off down here. See what we get. No, it's not quite off yet. The flat screw on, slotted screw on one side, and a 13 millimeter nut on the other end. Sometimes you think they're computer-aided design equipment was oriented backwards. But they do make good guitars. Okay, let's see if it gives me enough. Okay. Now, let's see if there is a vertical hole here I can use. See a hole down there, but do I see a hole at 90 degrees? No. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. By golly, there is a hole at 90 degrees. Okay, but I should probably. That's how I want it. So I want this one up. I want this hole up. Let me put this other one in. It has been solved. So there's a little hint for you. Okay, so this part is how I want it when it goes back into the cart. And we know holes going through that way, and this one does have a hole going this way. If I turn this at 90 degrees, there's a hole going this way, which is good. Okay, and I need the hole going on the side here. Let's put this bad boy in and line it up. Come on. Maybe I need to do a little minor tweaking to get this thing adjusted. You know, it would be good right now, it would be a Phillips screwdriver. With this pin. There we go. It's just very tight. I don't want to mess the threads up on this. It's got soft threads. Let's see. There it comes. You see it? There we go, success. Put the washer on. Put the nut on. And let's roll it out and look at that. Now the handle was in the orientation that I wanted it to be. Just for safety. I know one of the guys will probably pull this pin out if I leave it like that. Just let me turn it around. There we go. Come on, you can do it. There we go. There we go. Outstanding. Just tighten this guy up now and we're good to go. Well, I even learned a trick myself. So I've been fretting over this being at a 90 degree angle vertical. This way, even if I had a like a side-by-side or a 4x4, I can just hook it that way. Or I can take it off and hook it that way. But that's a good thing. And tighten that bad boy up. And then what we'll do is we'll put on the sides to the wagon. That ought to be an interesting jigsaw puzzle. So we have 8 Carter key pins of these guys,
Here's the hinges. There's two on each side. Now let's start with this side here. Let's make sure I'm doing this correctly. That seems more of a normal way of doing it. Let's see what happens. Yeah, put this way. This hinge gate could go in two different ways. So now when I fold it up, the way I put those pins in there with this part up, not going to work. Pull the pin out, turn the pin over. Now let's see what happens. Do the same thing over here. Should give us more room. Okay, now when we go up, we're in good shape. Do the same thing on the other side. I want it to end like that. Two ways to do that. You can do it that way, or you can do it the wrong way. Do it the wrong way, this part of the pin is going to be interfering. This way. There we go. Goes up. Now when it comes down, ooh, it's not coming down. So this has to go 180. Pull these pins out. This way. Okay, let's put this one like this. Oh.
goes up, goes down, goes up, goes down. See? You're getting there. And we know that somehow this drops in and it locks. And I thought for sure one of these would have a hole in it. Otherwise it's going to bounce all over the top of the tow bar. Does it go this way? Or does it go this way? Can you tell by the welds? Smoother welds on the outside maybe? Okay, it's not going to go that way. So it's got to go this way. Trial and error, trial and error, that's all we do.
Time for a consultation with the manual. Okay, after consulting the all-knowing Sandusky Garden utility cart manual, and in a paragraph that you can barely see anything on the images, I found the solution on how this friggin' thing sticks together. In the beginning, they said that you'll notice that these are pre-installed. It's a nut in this lever type thing. Okay, so you got a nut and lever type thing. I'm thinking something must go here in between these two metal tangs sticking out. Nope, that's not it. This fencing part with its cutout right here, this little tang, goes to the outside. So this raises up in the air and I'm pushing it that direction. So I have a little bit of meat down here. So that it goes through the slot. You see that? It just slides through the slot. And then it's pushed that way. And I pull that down. And it's locked in place. Obviously that's not in the manual. I'll do the same thing over here. Lift that up. Slide it down. If I need it a little bit tighter, snugglier, I can tighten that screw up a little bit. Tighten it up enough so it doesn't fall off in the line of duty. Now,
You know, and I also had to put this tail section part. I had to flip it around. I'll show you what I'm talking about. The pins right here didn't allow this to go all the way down. If I flipped it around that way, so it has to be able to hit the tire. These things are sort of dragging out there, so that front one probably have to be changed, which we can do that. So let's do that now. I had to close the door because the neighbor every Tuesday, this is Tuesday, decides they need to blow dead leaves all over the property. And where we live in a rural ranch area is dumber than a box of haircut clippings, as far as I'm concerned. But I'm just one neighbor. Okay. Hopefully. Let me take a quick peek. Make sure I've got this lined. And I do. Okay. Is this card in the right direction? And the answer is nope. Nope. These tangs have to be on this side. So we just pulled these quarter pins out. If you can get it backwards, I can get it backwards. Then you just flip it over. Tangs now are on facing me. I go down here. Make sure I only line up the straight part of the Carter key. I don't want the little wavy thing. I want this, just the straight part going in. Like that. Let me do that on the other side. There we go. Now, let's pull this up. Now you see, there it is. This one can lose use in tightening. Just snug it up a little bit so there isn't a big gap. Let's see how the other side looks. Up and pulling it outwards and sliding it down. Now there's a gap here of about a quarter of an inch, a little bit more. I'm just going to tighten it up a little bit. Doesn't rattle around too much. Lift it up, slide it, put it back down. So just a little bit. You don't want to really tighten, just want it snug so that the side gate is touching the end gate. I've got an air gap here about a quarter of an eighth of an inch. And for some of you, if there's too much noise, if you're watching on a phone and using the speakers or earbuds, yeah, the tools hitting metal is going to make a bit of a noise. You want to watch this, you might, it's better if you watch it on desktop or a laptop or a TV. It's got some big speakers on it. Check out some of that banging noise that you're hearing. Okay, now I'm going to go to the other end and secure that. Looked at some of the analytics on my YouTube channel, and discovered, quite surprised, that I have a pretty good female audience, and I think that may have to do with the goats and the ranch life. And I appreciate that. Okay, this one, you know, it's almost tight, but just a little bit more. Just a little bit. I'm pulling up and I'm pulling out. And this is what I want to hook. I want to hook it on the outside of this. We call these clevises. I want to hook it on the outside of the clevis. So I hold this up and I'm pulling it towards the outside of the pin. Then it's snugging right now. That's a good thing. Okay, that's good on that side. Let's take a look at this one. And the last point is always taking the most force and pressure. See what we got here. Okay. It's snug, but it actually has a little bit of air gap here. I'm gonna reduce. So there's what the cart looks like with a card on it. And if you look at the first video of me unboxing and assembling this, cart comes with a thin plastic sheet that goes right here in the bed. And you know, that would be good if you're dragging it in and out of a building and you don't want any dirt or debris to just flow right through this wire net mesh into the floor. So that plastic sheet fits right here in the bottom. It's got a sort of a diamond shaped pattern to it. It's very thin. But we're out in the field with goats and bales of hay and shavings and that type of stuff, so we don't need that. But this is, we're going to do one. You know, the boss said that we got to do one with the cart set up like this and one with a flat bed. But really, this can be a flat bed. You just have to set it up that way. There's the cart assembled. You can hear my neighbor now with his weed blower. I'm going to take a look at that. He's going to be there a day. You can see him up there. Right up there. Every Tuesday. You got a lot of trees to blow around, I'm telling you. Okay, so here's the cart with it finished. I got the handle like I want it. And I have these little side latches. What I was saying before is you bring this up and it pops out. And it comes down. This one I'm going to hold on to. And this one. So there it is with the sides down. You get a little bit of, you got about maybe 3-4 inches clearance from the ground up. And this tow bar handle is not really a problem. And if you want, you can just leave it alone. And there we go. The garden cart in all of its glory. Now, since I bought a second one, I need to go put it together. Thanks for watching. See you next time.